Hi everyone, I'm Priyanka and you're welcome to the Terrace Kitchen. In today's video, I'm going to show you the recipe of naan sandwich, that is naanwich. So let's get started. Let's first prepare the dough. So for that I've got 1 and 1/4 cup all-purpose flour. You can take half whole wheat flour and half maida. Add a little salt as per taste. Then add 1/4 cup milk and to the milk add 1/2 teaspoon sugar and mix till the sugar is dissolved. Add the milk to the flour. Add 2 teaspoon oil. Then add 1/2 teaspoon baking powder, 1/4 teaspoon baking soda, 2 tablespoon dahi or yogurt. This is plain, does not have any salt or sugar in it. Mix well. Then add a little water and make a medium soft dough. So add a little water at a time, do not add a lot of water in one go. Keep kneading the dough for 5 minutes and after that apply some oil and let this dough sit for 15 minutes. Do not forget to cover the dough with a cloth or a plate. For the potato filling, heat oil, 2 to 3 teaspoon oil in a pan. Then add 2 tablespoon cashew nuts. Fry the cashew nuts till they turn golden in color and then take them out. The cashew would add a very nice taste and crunch to your stuffing. For the potato stuffing, add 1 teaspoon ginger garlic paste. Fry till the raw smell is gone, keep the flame low at this time. Then add 4 small to medium sized boiled potatoes. Mash the potatoes directly in the pan or you can first mash them and then add. Then add 2 to 3 pinches of turmeric, 1 teaspoon coriander powder, 1/2 teaspoon red chili powder, 1/4 teaspoon garam masala. And finally salt to taste. Mix well. Keep the flame low at this time. Then add fresh chopped coriander, approximately 1 tablespoon or you can add more. And add the fried cashew nuts. Our potato stuffing is ready. For the chutney, take 2 tablespoon roasted chana dal, 1 to 2 green chilies, 1/4 teaspoon ginger, 1/4 teaspoon roasted cumin powder, 2 tablespoon yogurt, plain dahi without sugar or anything, 1/2 cup coriander, and 1/4 cup mint leaves. So make sure you wash the mint leaves and coriander before using. Then add salt. Blend this to a fine puree. Add a very little water if required because we've already added curd. Our delicious green chutney is ready. You may add a few drops of lemon juice to it if you like it. This tastes amazing with even tikkas. So let's move to the next step. Now knead the dough for 15 to 20 seconds and you would notice it would become smooth. Divide the dough into 4 equal sized portions. Take one of them. Flatten the dough with your fingers like this. Then add a few nigella seeds, also called as kalonji, and press with your fingers. And now sprinkle some maida and roll this dough. The thickness should be somewhat like paratha. Once you're done rolling, apply some water on the other side, that is not on the side we have placed the seeds on, the other side, and use an iron tawa for this recipe. Keep the flame between low to medium and cook for 10 to 12 seconds or 15 seconds or till you see a few bubbles, and after that flip your tawa, lower the flame, or you can switch between low to medium flame, but make sure you keep an eye, otherwise you may end up burning one place. Little extra charring in one place is okay, but overall it should look something like this. Now repeat the same steps and make more naans. Naan, naans, naan. Okay, so continue. If you want, you can also add some cheese or garlic while rolling the naan like this. You can check out my cheese naan and garlic naan recipe on the Terrace Kitchen. Do not use non-stick tawa, because when you use a non-stick tawa, the roti or the naan very quickly leaves the tawa and it becomes very difficult to flip the tawa and give that tandoor look. Looks fantastic. So take one naan and flip it over. apply some butter. You can use soft butter or you can apply melted butter. Next, apply some chutney. The layer of butter would prevent the naan from getting soggy because of the chutney, so don't skip butter. Then place potato masala. Press the masala a bit with the use of 2 spoons. Then again add chutney, so you can add more chutney as much as you like. Then place some onion, some chopped fresh coriander. Place the other naan on top and cut using a knife. A serrated knife would be better. Only for the naan to look pretty in my photographs, I am applying butter on top, but it would be difficult for you to eat the naan wedge if you apply butter on top, so make sure you apply butter inside. But if you don't mind getting your fingers messy, you can apply butter on top. If you like this recipe, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to Terrace Kitchen for more such wonderful recipes. Give this recipe a try and enjoy!